Okay, so before I start this next tour of the last world, I couldn't figure out what it's called. It'll probably be in the name though. I just want to say that if you've been impressed by some of the stuff I built so far, I think that's not nearly as impressive as this stuff that I built most recently. So what I'm about to show you is like the most recent stuff I've built in this world. So that's my artistic brain going to work. And what I'm gonna start with is this place here, which is I completely forgot what it's called. But let's get started. It's obviously modeled after a Mediterranean town. So you got all the fancy colors, all the vines, all the flowers, all the verticality. This is my first attempt at building a town of any sorts on like a badly vertical area, like a mountain. This is actually on a mountain, but I think it worked pretty good. So, of course, the centerpiece here is this fort. This fort actually came first. Then I was bored, and I built this. And this actually I built July 16, early no late June of 16, 2016. So that's, yeah, it's pretty recent. The most recent thing is just actually a small, just a small ranch. But this is where I stopped constructing the indoors, as you can see. So I have no reason to go inside any of these places. But that's what this is. I made sailboats, and they look okay from afar, but up close they're actually kind of not really useful at all. So like this, I tried the model after a more modern world, I suppose, because like those sailboats are look modern compared to the let's say medieval-esque ones I made over in Regius. But I don't like to think that that makes this in a different time period. I like to think that this is just a more industrialized country than Miatera over there. If you don't know what I'm talking about, neither do I. That's just the lore I came up with. But anyway, here's a nice beach I made. I had the originally this just completely dropped straight off, so I flattened it out a bit, made it a bit more of a desirable beach. On this side, I got this nice little fishing pond or something. And over here, I built all my vineyards. And well, that's it. It's just kind of, I'll take you through the streets because I'm impressed personally by the streets. I like the streets. You know, taking it to the streets. But yeah, you got your staircase, you gotta have those, or your very vertical roads. And yeah, because like I said, all the other builds I made were on completely flat ground. This was the first one which I tried to build on a mountain. And of course, it started with this here. This is the fortress of something. I called it something. And what I did is I built each tower. Oh crap. Okay. It does that sometimes in this part of the world. I built each tower, then I connected the walls. And I'm pretty proud of the way this actually turned out. Threw in some of these mossy bricks, and it looks pretty great. All these flowers here, I try to make them look like lavender and poppies, because I'm pretty sure that those are the two flowers. I know they grow, yeah, lavender and poppies, those are like the main flowers they grow, and sunflowers on the Mediterranean. Anyways, so I'll just quickly show you through the main compound of this. I tried to make this dual layered, like having a more, this is like kind of where the servants hang out, and then up here is like the real fancy old dancing queen party place with a little chapel I put here. Just a chapel. Let's jump up the stairs. Oh, forgot I made these stairs like these. These are okay. Actually pretty fancy, actually. And the completely empty upstairs. And something on top, too. No, there's no balconies. It's just, I did this with a lot of, yeah, I had to do this a lot because there's never enough room on the third floors. or anywhere with roofs that close that I can actually properly build anything indoors. So yeah, not gonna show much more indoors after that. Here's the gatehouse, though. This will be the last thing. Well, one of the few last things I'll show indoors. And, there's your, fancy, mechanism for hauling up the gate. So, I'm sorry if that insults you. Over here's more of the farm next to a big lake. That's where the road connects to this town here. Okay, what did I call this? Train station? Oh yeah, I created a train track this time. So there's your train and your telegraph lines. Believe it or not, this telegraph line actually stretches all the way to the other city, which you will see soon. And here's the bridge, the fancy bridge I had to make for the train to go on. Anyways, it's getting pretty... I made fake olive trees. Right here, I'll take you through this quickly. It's the, this is the most recent build I made. Well, yes and no, because you see the bottom of this building. Oh, shoot, I put it in caps lock. You see the bottom of this building. I made this, like, maybe 3 years ago. I made, just a few months ago, I made the top two floors. So, they don't blend the best, but I'll show it to you. So I called it Mr. Crimson's House of Oddity. And Mr. Crimson is just like a fake guy I made up. I just pretend like he owns all the weird stuff I made. So that includes La Villa Strangiato, and I left it with that. Now it fits in with the lore. Am I right? No, I'm not. But I'll show you in it. Again, I used... It's really fancy in here. This is like the brand new shulker boxes, they called it. I use that for the floors, even though they're kind of like chests. So I'm just going to kind of show... There's not much going on except for the floor detail. There's the giant fake lake. I use the purpur in here, which I honestly don't really like using, but I thought I might try it. I got a bunch of stained glass floors. A weird balcony. So this one, it isn't that impressive, if you ask me. But I tried to do new things, because I hadn't really done anything that new feeling for a while. So I used a bunch of the new objects. Although what I tried to do and didn't work out is I tried to make the roof spiral, but I just couldn't figure it out. So eventually I settled on making it spiral like that. But it doesn't look like that from down here. But I digress. Now I'm going to kind of keep my head down for a while here, because you can see the other city over there. Right here's the train track again. This one kind of pissed me off because I had to raise it up, but it had to go up a hill too. And I don't think trains can actually go uphill, I heard. Or they can't go uphill that effectively. So screw it. It is a steam train I designed for that. But let's go over to Rhoads. Freaking squids. I don't know why they don't have any other marine life. You know, just passive marine life in this game. So there you can see the foot of it. I'm just trying to let everything spawn in before I look up. Anyway, this one's built on the sea, as you can see, but, as you can see. But, I only put one boat in it, because I didn't feel like crafting many boats. But this city, it's supposed to be industrial. So I modeled it kind of after industrial London, and again, I was kind of inspired, and I started playing, or building it, when I was playing Assassin's Creed Syndicate. So, that's what I built. This was the first building, industrial building I tried to make. And then I actually didn't work this way first, I worked to the side. See, I started here, and I can remember this process, because I built it so recently. I built it last year, and I remember building through the night and being really depressed because I had just got my wisdom teeth out. Now it's like almost exactly a year ago, because I think it happened during Teachers' Convention, and it's the first day of Teachers' Convention right now, so there you go. Anyways, I want to point out this part, because I like this. I made damaged walls, and the scaffolding's got the brick. I try putting these little things into the world to make it seem just that much more believable, right? Because, so like, these broken walls you would see in an actual, you know, industrial city, and you would need to fix it. So I didn't actually add too many of that. Anyways, here's the first steam engine what the hell do they call it? Steamboat I built, and the only steamboat. And here's the dock. Because I wasn't too certain how to make the docks, so I made it square. It looks okay. But, like, I don't really have much more places to do that. And here is a fast travel to Regius. I put a lot of those in. But see, this is like one of two or three steam-driven objects I tried to make using these blocks. So I had to do, I used obsidian, the black clay, and coal in some places. And I had to use a lot of different black shades. So you'll see what I mean when I show you the train engine. Here's one of the, well, no, here's all of it, basically. I'm just gonna kind of slowly work my way through this. You got your little, gungy old, laundry washing holes down here. They kind of draw it in from the river over here. See, I wasn't sure exactly how I was going to design it when I was starting over here, so I built this thing, which you probably would never see in an industrial city because they would have had to use so many horses and carriages. So the suspension bridge wouldn't have worked at all. You can see some of the smokestacks in the background, and something big is loading in, which I will show you right about now. That is the cathedral, in case you didn't know. And this is kind of like my pride and joy in this game, not gonna lie, because, like, this is actually the first build I think I can say that I drew blueprints for, or I drew plans for it in a sketchbook. And my sketchbook went missing, so I can't show it to you, but I drew it all up. I drew both sides, how they would look, in the front, how it would look, and the dome here. The dome was the hardest thing to do. I think it turned out all right, as I keep trying to say. But, like, I'm very proud of it. Like, to me, it's the best looking thing I've ever made. Like, La Villa Strangia is good, and I'm really proud of that, but I'm really proud of this. This took absolutely forever to make. I had to go. For some reason, I felt the need to do all this detail work down here. All these gigantic old all this mural stuff? Is that what I'm trying to say? Masonry? Maybe, yeah. And, like, I had to take screenshots, open it up in a side window, minimize this, then fly over, then do it again. Or did that turn out? Yeah, okay. But see, that's what I had to do for every one of these tiles. And then, of course, these two towers are identical, except for the tops. So I had to deal with that again. But I used all these armor stands as decoration. I thought they looked like little statues, so when they had their iron armor on, so I threw them in there. And I'm gonna drink a potion right now and take you through the interior. So I worked really hard on keeping everything making sense. So I got my pillars I made sure everything had a point. Like all these arches. It was really important that they had points like this. So it couldn't be 2x2. See, the first thing I did is pick a starting point for the center, which was here. And that's the center of the whole thing. And that's a mistake I made with the Dolmas Batayan, which is why it looks so kind of chunky. It's because I made it 2x2 for some reason. So this looks a lot better. I'm just going to kind of shut up and both admire it and show you so you can admire it. And this is just the front. Okay, anyways, let's go in. So as you can see, I worked really hard on all these patterns on the side. Really making sure I gave some depth with this clay. Oh, crap. Again, I built this city on a completely flat plane, so which was pretty necessary to make this look as nice as it does. That's the big centerpiece of the whole thing, I'd say. This floor. Now, looking up, there's the entire inside of the dome. So as we can see, I worked really hard in the stained glass, too. Make complicated patterns. Man. This is all really hard. A lot of windows. A lot of layers of windows. The sides here. They're identical, so there's a lot of cloning going on. See, I made these chandeliers in hopes that it would actually light the place up, but the lighting is the one thing that's hard to get right in this game, which is why it's a godsend to have this thing. Because if I had to, like, put torches down so I could see what I was building in here, it could not have wound up good at all. Anyways, here's your, this is your altar. I actually tried to make it look good, and I think it does. Oh boy, I've been sitting for a while taking you through this place. Anyways, this is just like my biggest feat, this church, this cathedral. I called it something. I do have its name written down in one of the houses. Let me check. I called it something. Just gonna break through the roof. No, I got rid of it. Dick. Oh no, there it is. Yeah, this I took the map picture while I was still building it. So as you can see, like I didn't have that last part. I had to blast. Oh, shoot the lag. I had to blast a bunch of the desert off. This is actually built. Like, it doesn't look like it, because I completely covered this desert in grass. Because I didn't like the look of it at the end. But, it's a desert biome I'm in right now. And, I had to blast a bunch of sand to make room for the city. And as you can see, like, my process there. And I called it Magna Domina. So there you go. Oh, shoot, I hope I didn't break anything off. Nope, we're good. But anyways, that's that. Actually, I will show you, I'll show the insides up here, too. Man, I wish it didn't lag this bad. So I use a lot of spiral staircases to get around. Because I don't like using ladders. I only use ladders if there's no other way for me to put stairs in. Which is why this design of staircase is good, because it only needs 6x6. Or 3x3. It needs 5x5 if you want to put railings in. And in a build this size, that's not very hard to do at all. Anyways, I'm going to show you into the... This is the gear room, which actually looks kind of like gears. I somehow managed to pull it off. And, of course, this is the clock tower I'm in, so that was necessary. Okay, on the other side, Just another prayer room, and at the top, there's the bells. And I'm not sure if I made very fancy bells, but I might have. Oh, no, that's a reasonably fancy bell. It's hard to make bells because they're so curved. And you can't exactly do that very easily with a bunch of blocks. So, that one looks okay. So just kind of go around the outside, show some of the outside detail. Oh yeah, here's another thing. I used these wither skulls just as like to look like mini statues. They look okay from afar, but up close it looks kind of makes the cathedral look a little satanic. That's okay. Anyways, I'm just gonna quickly glance over these things too. So believe it or not, I actually gave these most of these roads names because there were so few of them. So this is Domina Avenue for the cathedral. Dolores Street, not sure where that comes from. Made a lot of pubs because that was a big thing in the industrial times. And this again, Mr. Crimson. Saw his weird house of oddities, and he's got his museum of oddities here. Okay. I'm pretty sure I gave another name back here. Jerry Sharfway. Good for Jerry. Or Gary, isn't it? I don't know. Here's... okay, this is the Houses of Parliament that I made here. It's got the best flag I've ever made. That is a nice flag, I think. But yeah, I also drew pictures up for this one. So this one had blueprints as well. So they both the cathedral and this turned out really good because of that. They got their statue here. I haven't made many statues because they're kind of hard to make, but this one looks okay. Of course, you got the maze, the courtyard. I'll show you the other... statue... This one looks really good. I actually kind of wish I put this one by the Houses of Parliament and that other one here, because this one looks so much friggin' awesomer than that. But you know, what can you do? Like, I don't think I could recreate one looking this good. Must be because of the cape, but I don't know. Oh, the lag, man. I'm sorry. But I actually built this whole place dealing with lag like this. And, okay. I will now show you the map. So, see, there's Rhoads. This down there's train station. There's a ranch there. Up here is the House of Oddities, and Fort Bluestone, and Golivae is what they called those places up there. So the fort is Fort Bluestone, and Golivae is the town. And Alandria is just on the map right here, Alandria Town. So just to give you an idea. And Redbridge Strait, yeah. But yeah, I think... Like, I like Regius, and like all my other builds are really awesome. But I think none of it comes close to Rhoads. Rhoads is like my crowning achievement at the moment. Like, I did this all myself. All by myself, man. It was nuts. But anyways, here's more of the Houses of Parliament. I made sure to use these skylights, give some light to the place. It works because, like, after the cathedral, I realized chandeliers wouldn't really do the trick. But yeah, and you know what? I remember listening to Aerosmith watching while building this one. So there you go. Really nice Houses of Parliament. I'm actually gonna stop, do a slow pan. Well, okay, anyways, so moving on, there's only a few more things I'd like to show. Right here, I'm not sure if I put the road sign. This is supposed to be the president's house, kind of based off whatever the one they call it in friggin' London. Or the Prime Minister's house, sorry. So yeah, he's just got a nice place. But I gave myself a house right next door. And I always try to go do something special here. Map of the city. Oh, I called it Milborg. So it's either Milborg or Rhoads. Huh, which one's better? I couldn't tell you. Well, actually, I'd like to focus in on this map right now because you can see the, you can just see the level of detail around the cathedral. So I got, first of all, I got the park around. Sorry, I'm covering my mouth. I shouldn't do that. I got the park around it, and then I got all the special, what am I trying, all the special road, and then the cathedral. And, yeah, there's just my nice place. It's got some skylights. You know, I wouldn't mind living in a place like this. Although, you know, I'd rather not live in a city. Which, again, I don't know why I built two huge cities in one Minecraft world. Because I don't like the city. I don't like being surrounded by a bunch of people. I like nature. But you know what? It's a design. Okay, this is called Patterton Avenue. This is just a big monument through in it. Here's a bank. And I only specify that because I'll show you later. New Strand Street. Here's another pub there. Tory Lane. I gave all these pubs names, I think. I was looking at a few of them, like this one. This is the Black Poplar. So, yeah. Not the best at naming pubs. But I don't drink, so there you go. Now this here is a little college. Because again, like, people do need to be educated, otherwise they'll be so stupid they'll forget to breathe. And this has skylights, which again I used over here. Put some skylights on. Over there's the train station. That looks really cool. I'll get to that later. I just want to take you over here and show some things. Here's another, the General's Pot pub. The General's Pot, man, he must be stoned. Here is, I had to blow away a huge portion of a mountain, and then I had to try and make it look natural. So, maybe it does, I don't know. Like, I'm not working on it anymore, because landscaping's one of the most boring things to do in the game, not gonna lie. Or when you're building. I just want to quickly show the, I use purple bricks here again. The Deep Purple Inn. I was listening to Fireball when I decided to do that. But there you go. It's freaking weird. I didn't finish up the tops, but I was just doing some, using some purple in the inside. And then just over here, we got a marketplace. And then, oh, it's raining. I'm actually gonna set the time today and then toggle downfall. Actually, that shouldn't matter because I'm beginning to feel the strain, man. That shouldn't matter because most of this city is in a desert, like right here. You can see by the grass. Now I just want to get showing. By the way, aside from the pubs and the bank, none of these places have any designed interior. Well, the pubs, the bank, the cathedral, most of these houses along Patterton Avenue, and the house department, if I haven't said that yet. But there you go. Over here is the workers' slums, or whatever they call it. You know this style of housing, right? Just like brick next to each other all the way. And I made sure to add that detail because the factories were going here. Now this factory is kind of based off the Battersea Power Plant, which was on the front of Pink Floyd's Animals album. And that's the second reference to Pink Floyd I made in the world. Well, anyways, it's just like, yeah, a power plant of some sorts. And it's right next to a river, so it's got one of these tugboats in there. I think that's what they look like. You got your cranes. Whoa, boy. Like, that's why I had to build it with, man. The Lutenist's Fiddle. Okay. Oh, crap. another factory there. I tried to make that look more like a garment factory. Actually, I put some machines in that one. That one's empty, but this one's got some machines in it. It's hard to do a lot of these customized interiors without special blocks or and just using the blockiness of Minecraft. Because I did this all in vanilla Minecraft, right? No mods. Like, all, every creative thing I did had no mods. Well, except for one that, like, basically just allowed me to switch between survival and creative and allowed me to spawn in some blocks before I actually decided to just have it permanently set to creative mode. Anyways, here's the train I was talking about, right next to the H&L factory. Don't know what that means. Don't care. But yeah, you see what I mean by using a whole bunch of different black blocks in order to make the train look pretty good. And it does look damn good, if I do say so myself. I mean, that's a train. You can fiddle with your thing here. Try to give it something that looked like controls. Like, I was actually impressed how well this turned out, because this was hard to make, that train. And, of course, here's the train station. Lovely. I actually really enjoyed making this glass thing, because it was, like, gloriously hard. Now, I'm going to follow the rails for a little bit. Actually, I just want to point out a fun fact. The only reason I put this telegraph here is because while I was building the city, I listened to Dicks out of a song called Telegraph Road by Dire Straits, which is a friggin' good song. But I was really feeling it when I was building a city, because it's kind of about building a city as it is. So it really worked out, and I put a telegraph pole along a telegraph road because of it. And here's just a ranch. This is the second most recent thing I made, this ranch. And I just tried to make it look as detailed as possible. And I used these new grass road blocks. Got your cows, got your pigs. The only reason I made it is because I thought there'd be more room to put cows and pigs, but there really weren't, but it's okay. There's your hay bales. Look rolled. There's more chunk glitches over there, which is good. I like the barn. The barn looks good inside. You got Bessie and Betty. Inside, it's actually pretty nicely designed. Well, crap. Anyways, I shouldn't be dwelling too long on this, because what I want to do is there's two more things I want to show, other than a slow flyover. Believe it or not, I have something to show in the sewers, because when I built Regius, I'd wanted to put in sewers, but I didn't really have the patience. But in this one, I figured it would fit in well. Actually, oh wait, I'm going to screech to a halt right now. This here. This I built in survival mode a long time ago. And I found a desert because I wanted cactus. Grabbed the cactus, built a pyramid. Then I left and I completely forgot about it until I came over this way. Selected a place to start building. And started building the city. But then like I realized this wasn't a natural spawning thing. I thought this was a natural spawning temple. Temple or forest... desert pyramid. You know what I'm talking about. The jungle temples and stuff. I thought this was one of them, just in the desert. But once I built this and I realized it was something I built in survival, I couldn't bring myself to demolish it, even though it looks really out of place in this huge industrial city. So I left it. It's caged off, so like it's not like you can really see what's in it if you're on foot. But yeah, that's the thing. Now, where did I put the entrance? Oh, yeah. You can actually go in through here. And I have a funny story to tell about the sewers. The sewers are actually kind of disgusting to me, even though they're not disgusting, but it's because I listened to Frank Zappa's Joe's Garage while building it. And if you don't know, that involves robots banging men. Gay robots banging men. So... if that's not your thing, and that kind of makes you sick to the stomach, well then, good, because it did me, and I listed out while I was building this, and I eventually gave up, because it was just too freaking weird. And that's me, I built La Villa Strangiato. It's just too weird for me. So I'm just going to quickly take you through these. Because there's one thing I want to show you. Just, again, like I said with the Black Mark and Regius, I felt the need to add some criminal activity. So, wait, no, it's not down here. It's mostly just a straight shot through the sewers, but there's some tangents, but they definitely look like tangents. Oh god, it just froze. I need to get this done quick, so I'll just show you this, and then I'll wrap it up. Down here, I did this. That doesn't go anywhere. I just wanted to make it look like it did. I did that a lot, like just vent it off places, make a dead end, just you can't see the dead end. Okay. And you got this here. It's a criminal, it's a tunnel from the sewers, and you can break into the, that's the bank vault in there. I'm not gonna bust in there myself, because it's kind of a hassle to do so. I need to break a bunch of blocks. Even from the bank, I need to break my way through the door in order to get in there. But that's about everything I built in this world. And I'm pretty sure I've been sitting here for about 2 hours, so that could maybe like 3 hours. That explains how huge it is. I mean, like, that's grade 7 to grade 12 that I build all this stuff. And this is the crowning achievement. And you know what? I'm willing to bet that if one day, soon probably, I'll get bored and I'll probably build something else crazy. But that's the world. So, hope you enjoyed listening to my sick, sniffling, monotone voice telling you about this world. But that's, I felt like I needed to get it out there because it's definitely like, it's like my world, right? I built everything here, and it's nuts to think that when I see how much I've done and how long it takes me to describe just even a fraction of some of the stuff I've done. But, well, I wouldn't say a fraction, kind of most of it. But yeah, so if you're still awake, then, I hope you enjoyed. I'm gonna go flying.